Pastor Ben Lim here, and did you know that there's three types of fires that you can experience in this life? That's right, three types of fires. Now, it's so important for you to know that these three types of fires are available for all of us. However, they're not all good for us. So I'm going to teach you and talk to you today about these three types of fires. Number one, it's the fires of testing. Number two, it's the fires of the Holy Spirit. And number three, it's the fires of perversion, or otherwise called strange fire. Let's go over to the fires of testing, because there's so many things that happen in life. And most people think that it's the fires of the enemy. Whatever you're experiencing, know this, that God is testing. He's refining. He's purifying, just like the gold that has to be burned in the fire. And as it's burning in the process, you gain the most precious and the most pure form of gold. Here in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, we can read from verses 11. The Apostle Paul says, "No one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." Verse 12. "Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold," you see it says here in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 11, "for no one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." Verse 12, "Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, or straw, each one's work will become manifest. For the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed by fire. And the fire will test," some say test, "what sort of work each one has done." So in the testings of life, not just on the judgment day, when we face Jesus at the throne of judgment, not just then, but even now today, when we go through the tests of life, it is proving what kind of foundation our lives are built upon. Now, Apostle Paul so articulately articulates that there's different materials that will be left out from the fire. When the fires of life come, when the fires of testing come, what will you have? What's going to remain? Is there going to be gold? Is there going to be silver, precious stones, wood, hay, or straw? Now, these are different dimensions or levels of works. You see, not everything you do on earth will be gold. Not everything you do will be silver. Some will be precious stones. Some will be wood. Some will be hay. Some will be straw. Now, you see, they all have value. However, wood, hay, and stubble or straw can all be burnt up very quickly. Precious stones can also be broken very quickly. I don't know about you, but I don't want my works of righteousness to be deemed as dirty rags. I want the things I do to be like gold and silver. Some people, they work hard all their life to only have wood, hay, and stubble. Let me ask you, how grounded is your foundation, and how solid are you? When the fires of life come, it tests who you are, and it tests the works that you've done. Now, that's the first fire. It's called the fires of testing. And if you're anything like me, I love going through tests. I love the tests. Why? Because I know I'm going to be upgraded. I know that's what proves who I really am. Someone makes fun of you. Someone antagonizes you. A problem, a challenge, a challenging situation comes. How are you going to react or respond? That is the fires of life, or the fires of testing. I declare, you will not have wood, hay, stubble, but you will have precious gold that remains. The second type of fire is, of course, the fire of the Holy Spirit. You know, Jesus says in the book of Acts, "Do not leave Jerusalem until you're baptized in the Holy Spirit and fire." John the Baptist said, There's another one coming after me. He will baptize you in fire. You see, the Holy Spirit is an all-consuming fire. In the book of Hebrews, the Bible says, I am jealous, jealous. Your God is an all-consuming fire. And so when God gets a hold of you, you are filled with the fire of the Holy Spirit, which stands for zeal, stands for passion, stands for purity, stands for the love of God. And you begin to have that power from within. Now, some of you feel lukewarm. Some of you feel cold. Some of you feel like you've lost your fire. I pray that God will baptize you in the Holy Ghost and in fire, so that you will destroy and overcome the works of the enemy. Someone say, Holy Ghost, fire. Now, the third type of fire is not so good. It's called strange fire. You may have heard of this. Now, let's go to scripture here. Many people move in strange fire, and they do not know. Leviticus chapter 10, verses 1 to 3. And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer and put fire within and put incense and offered strange fire before the Lord, which God commanded them not to do. And there went out from the strange fire, or the fire of the Lord, and devoured them, and they died before God. Now you see, this term strange fire has to do with acts of worship that has not been ordained by God. Too many people are trying to do good things, but God's not in it. They're trying to do things for him, but he never led them to do it. That's called strange fire, folks. It has a form of godliness, but it has no power. Religion, tradition, the religious spirit, religiosity, is like strange fire. It may look good to the eyes of man, but God does not accept it. God rejects it. God is not pleased with it. And he says, this is strange fire. It is detestable in my sight. Now, many good and willing people are trying to do good things for God, but it's not the real fire. It's strange fire. It's not an acceptable, pleasing sacrifice, but it's off, it's strange, it's disorderly, and is not of God. It's of the flesh. Let me ask you this. Have you ever experienced these three types of fires? The fires of testing, the fires of the Holy Ghost, maybe even some strange fire. You see, the fires of testing stand for purity. The fires of the Holy Spirit stand for power. But strange fire stands for perversion. Have you ever experienced any of these three types of fire? I pray that you will have the gold and that you will receive the fire of the Holy Ghost that gives you power from on high. People of God, this is Pastor Ben Lim. I hope you enjoyed today's teaching. Comment below what spoke to you the most, and I pray for the fire of Jesus Christ to burn bright within you. In Jesus' name, God bless.